Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a double exposure image from two photos. If you'd like to use this image, I provided its link in my video's description or project files. For the second photo, you'll get the best results if the person you choose has deep shadows on one side, like these examples that I got from Shutterstock.com. It doesn't matter if they're color or black and white. However, if your photo has general lighting, like this one, I'll show you how to transition it into deep shadows. If you'd like to use this photo, I provided its link. The first step is to create a selection around your subject. For this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool. I'll make the tool size 10 pixels and drag over the subject to select it. I can click either the Refine Edge button or go to Select and Refine Edge. I did an in-depth tutorial on Refine Edge, so if you'd like to watch it, I provided that link as well. I'll click Smart Radius and adjust its size to make the brush big enough to cover the edge of the hair. I'll output it as a new layer and click OK. Remove all its color by pressing Ctrl-Shift-U on Windows or Command-Shift-U on a Mac. To adjust its brightness and contrast, open your Levels window by pressing Ctrl or Command-L. Drag the white and black input levels to the point just before where the histogram really starts to rise and click OK. To make room for your tropical trees, make sure your subject is positioned to one side of your document. Just press V to open your Move tool and drag it over. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Click the FX icon and click Gradient Overlay. Change the Blend Mode to Multiply and click the gradient bar. Click the black-white gradient and click OK. Make the angle minus 180 degrees and the scale 40%. Then click OK. To restore some of the brightness on her face, click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the active layer. Open your Brush tool and Brush Picker. We'll adjust the size in a moment. Make the hardness 0% and the opacity and flow 100%. Then press Enter or Return. To make your brush larger or smaller, press the right or left bracket keys on your keyboard. Now, brush over your subject in areas where you'd like to restore its original brightness. Click the bottom layer to make it active, and click the New Layer icon to make a new layer above it. We'll fill the empty layer with white. To do this, press Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the Fill window. Or you can go to Edit and Fill. Open the Flyout menu, click White, and click OK. Open the image you'd like to blend into the person. You can use this one, but feel free to use anything you want, as long as its bottom is relatively dark and dense and ends up somewhere at its top. Ultimately, we want the top of the image to be pure white. If you're using this image too, open your Dodge tool. If your foreground color isn't white, press D on your keyboard to make your foreground and background colors black and white respectively, and then press X to invert them. Make the range highlights and the exposure 100%. Adjust the size of your tool and brush over the sky. To place the trees onto your subject, press V to open your Move tool and drag it up onto the tab of your subject. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the image and release. We want to place the trees on top of the person. To do this, just drag the trees layer to the top of the Layers panel. Go to Edit, Transform, and rotate 90 degrees clockwise. Let's temporarily reduce its opacity so we can see the subject under it. To resize and position it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go inside the Transform and position the trees, or what else your image is, over your subject. You can always reposition and resize it later if you want. Press Enter or Return to accept it. Increase its opacity back to 100%. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to the active layer. Press B to open your brush tool. Increase your brush size a bit and brush over the left side of the trees to mask them out. To restore back areas of the trees, press X to invert your foreground and background colors and adjust the brush size if you need to. Now, brush over those areas of the trees that you want to restore back. Continue to finesse your image, brushing in and restoring back areas until the two images create a double exposure. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.